We've got the brand new 16-inch MacBook Pro here, and I do photo and video for a living, so my machine matters a lot. This is a very, very welcome upgrade. I've also got another photographer here. This is Jason Ang here.
Hello.
You may have heard him on the podcast, stalmanpodcast.com. He is also a professional photographer. I think we have a pretty good comparison here. The specs are sort of similar for their times. This is my 2018 model with a black sticker on it. But this was the second from the top processor, whereas right now we're using the top of the line 16-inch. But what's really incredible is that this fully specced out is still $800 cheaper than what I paid, $800 Canadian, cheaper than what I paid for my 15-inch. And we're getting almost top of the line in a lot of ways in terms of GPU and processor. But enough talk, let's do some real world tests because benchmarks, they don't tell you anything. So I'm gonna look at all of the bottlenecks that I hit all the time. The first one is building previews. Often have to wait for a long time once you import a card for everything to get done. So right now I've got the same photos on each computer. Let's just generate smart previews for both of them, see how long they take. We had about a 23% improvement on the new MacBook Pro. That's not bad. Let's check out my next bottleneck, and especially for like wedding photographers, event photographers, when you're shooting really high volume, when you export all your JPEGs, that can take forever. Let's export a big batch, see how long it takes. All right, again, we have 23% difference between the two of them. Jason, how's that make you feel?
23% is almost 25.
It's like a quarter, yeah.
Yeah, and I mean, go to 6 to 8 processors, it's a really nice difference to see.
So I might be used to sometimes waiting half an hour for that, like a big export.
Right.
So if you're saving, what, like 7.5 minutes out of half, like that's right. Substantial, that's good.
Right, right, right. And if you are processing out 3, 4, things a day, like we often do, you could be saving, you know, an hour or two of time.
Or I bet if you're using your camera, because you shoot on the A7R4, which is how many megapixels?
42.
Yeah, so I bet if you bump up those megapixels, then you start to appreciate that even right. More, because the 5D isn't the biggest megapixel camera
right.
Out there.
All right,
I'm gonna test out some HDR panoramas on the A7 III. This is gonna be a lot of photos and should really stress the processor. And I'm in the perfect place to do it, Lake Louise. Now, let's do a more intense real-world test that hits a bunch of different parts of the machine. We're gonna start in Lightroom and we're gonna generate an 18-image HDR panorama. From there, we will export it, open it up into Photoshop, and run the same action on both machines that just goes through a bunch of complicated steps, including generating a optical blur, create some noise, add some different lighting effects, and finally compress itself into one layer and save itself out and see how long that whole process takes. And this time we're seeing some amazing improvements. This is a big jump with the 16-inch over the 2018 15-inch. So the total time for all of those steps was 9 minutes and 34 seconds on the 15-inch MacBook Pro. And then on the 16-inch, it was 2 minutes and 24 seconds. So now we're looking at close to a 400% improvement. That's more like it. That's really impressive. Most of that time was taken up by generating the HDR panorama and then the Photoshop and saving actions. That was a bit more of a marginal difference. Once I generated this 60 megapixel file, both computers handled it pretty smoothly as I manipulated it in Photoshop. They're both quite responsive. I still noticed that, you know, around 20 to 30% improvement on the new MacBook, but things like Healing Brush, Content Aware Fill, they both still responded similarly. Now, I'll also say that I think you're gonna see a much bigger difference if you are using a metal optimized program like Pixelmator or Affinity Photo, neither of which I use, so I didn't test them for this. I hope somebody else does, but metal optimization goes a long way and I want Adobe to start moving in that direction too. Now we're in the big part of Jason's studio and we're gonna do some tests with some more professional photography software, Capture One. But before we do, I want to thank this video's sponsor, Clean My Mac X. Instead of just telling you what it does, let's try it out for real here on my old 15-inch MacBook Pro. What it's going to do is scan my whole hard drive for anything that it can clean up. So a lot of that is big old files that aren't just being used. There's all sorts of system junk that can safely be cleared away and doesn't impact your use of the machine at all. Just recovers space that you need for your files. On my system, I can see that it found 9.3 gigs of unneeded files. That's great. Wow, a lot of this is user cache files. We've got 7.3 gigabytes of cache that I don't need. iTunes cache, great. Okay, it's just a bunch of cache. It's a bunch of stuff that I'm not using, so I can safely delete all of that. Clean My Mac also has great antivirus and anti-malware services, so it's gonna, again, scan your system looking for anything that might be doing something nefarious.
It says that it actually found one thing. Let's see what this is. Oh, interesting. I don't know what this is, if you guys know, but it found something called OS X Lame Pyre. That sounds bad. It says that it is a backdoor threat, so I'm gonna neutralize that. So thankfully, Clean My Mac may have just saved me from some unauthorized access to my machine. That's what Clean My Mac did for my system. Click the link in the description below to see what it can do for yours. They have a free trial, so you can give it a shot. Thanks again to Clean My Mac X for sponsoring this video. Next up is Capture One. For any non-professional photographers watching, you may be a little less aware of this software because it's not quite as mainstream popular as Lightroom, but in studios, pros use it all the time, including Jason. Jason's a Capture One user. I've been thinking about it. Think I should move over?
I think if you start working in studio.
Yeah, Jason's telling me all the time that Capture One's where I want to be.
It's where you need to be if you're tethering.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I know it's great software. I really like it. I like to use it more. Where's our bottleneck? What are we going to test?
Like any software, whether it be Final Cut or Lightroom, at the end, when you need to process out 100 files, that's when you see the real time suck.
So we'll do the exact same export, the exact same files, see how it does. The results are in, and the MacBook Pro 16-inch beat the old one by 27%.
Right.
A little bit more.
Almost 30%.
Yeah, the other one's almost a quarter, now we're almost at a third. Another thing to notice, though, is that the export from Capture One did take a little longer than Lightroom.
Yeah, slightly.
Yeah.
I think it was 20 seconds or something like that for 100 frames or 120 frames.
It's not all about time when you're choosing between these two.
This is a tether and processing software only, whereas Lightroom is kind of encapsulating a lot more.
Yeah, and what's kept me from switching so far is like catalog management. I haven't found the way I would manage a catalog in Capture One. Anyway, that's not what this video is about. There are a few other photography-related things I want to address with this computer. First of all, we do have a bigger screen, which is great. The 16 inches is very welcome. It's mostly in the bezels, even though the body is a little bit bigger, but we do not have an SD card reader yet. I didn't really expect it to happen. It will never come back. A lot of different pros have different needs, so some cameras use a CFast card reader, compact flash card reader, SD card reader. You never know what you're going to need. So not everybody even needs the same cards. I get it, but I still would have liked one. Now, another really great new feature that's not part of the 16-inch exclusively, but is just new to Catalina, that's Sidecar, where you're able to stream your monitor to an iPad so that you basically get dual monitors. And I don't even have a cable running between them. It's doing all this over AirPlay 2. And I think this is gonna be incredibly useful to a lot of creatives. Right now I've got Final Cut running and I'm using this to display all of the clips in the project. And over here I can make my window display a much bigger video. So I have way more real estate to work with still a relatively small package. I get dual monitors. I know I said this was a video for photographers, but I found some crazy results for filmmakers too. I was exporting my raw C200 files for this video and on my 2018 computer, it took 3 hours and 21 minutes. That's typical. On the new 16-inch, it took 48 minutes. That's about 400% faster for something I do all the time. I thought maybe I was crazy and doing something wrong, so I made a few changes. I could still get the same results. So then I went over to Final Cut to export this video, which is a mix of AVC files, H.265, and also ProRes. It took 12 minutes and 29 seconds on my old computer, and on the new 16-inch, it took 5 minutes and 9 seconds. In 2016, when they announced the previous design, a lot of the higher-end professionals complained that you couldn't upgrade it enough. And now, with the new cooling system and bigger batteries, they've addressed pretty much all those problems. I mean, the best thing is you can take the storage up to 8 terabytes. I know that there's gonna be headlines about how insanely expensive you can make this machine if you upgrade it all the way. But you know what? That 8 terabyte hard drive that you can buy, which doubles the price of the machine. I mean, it's really expensive. I'm not buying one. But it will speed up your workflow probably more than any other upgrade. When I got mine, I put 2 terabytes in it, which cost me some extra money. But when you have to unplug and plug back in external drives all the time, that really slows you down. Even if they're fast, the SSD in here is faster, and just not having to manage anything external will improve your workflow so much. I mean, if you're building your machine right now, definitely upgrade the SSD. This review unit has been amazing, but I would love to hear from you guys what you think the perfect photographer's MacBook Pro build will be, because I haven't ordered one for myself yet. Let's see if I do. I just want to say I'm really glad Apple was listening to the complaints about the last generation. It was good, but not great, and I think we might have a great MacBook Pro on our hands right now. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.